हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज यूनिट 3 सिंगल फेज एसी सर्किट। दिस इज द सिलेबस ऑफ यूनिट 3। आई हैव डिवाइडेड दिस सिलेबस इनटू 4 मॉड्यूल्स और 4 लेक्चर्स। विद इन 4 लेक्चर्स वी विल बी कवरिंग द सिलेबस ऑफ दिस यूनिट 3। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर आई विल ट्राई टू कवर this much portion of the syllabus: study of AC circuit consisting of pure resistance, pure inductance and pure capacitance. So this will be the lecture 1, starting with pure resistance. Purely resistive circuit. Consider a simple circuit consisting of pure resistance R ohms, which is connected across a voltage whose equation will be V is equal to Vm sine of omega t. According to Ohm's law, we know that I is equal to V divided by R. You might be knowing Ohm's law, I is equal to V divided by R. What is V? V is the applied voltage, whose equation is Vm sine of omega t. So substituting V is equal to Vm sine of omega t into the equation of current. From where we got this equation? This is according to Ohm's law. Therefore, I is equal to Vm sine of omega t divided by R. This is second equation. Now, the standard equation of current is I is equal to Im sine of omega t plus phi. This is the standard equation. We have to compare this obtained equation with the standard equation. What we are getting? At the left hand side, it is I equal to Vm divided by R. Before this sine term, Vm divided by R. And here in the standard equation, before the sine term, it is Im. It means the Im is equivalent to Vm divided by R. Are you getting this? This is the maximum value of current, which is equal to maximum value of voltage divided by the resistance. Okay. Now, in the standard equation, there is phi. But in this obtained equation, there is no phi. It means for purely resistive circuit, the value of phi is 0. This is very important to remember. For purely resistive circuit, there is no phase angle, or phi is equal to 0. Okay. Therefore, we can write I is equal to Im sine of omega t with phi is equal to 0. This is the final equation of current. In exam, it may ask to obtain the expression of current. So this is to be obtained. Do remember, within the 3 steps you can obtain this equation. It is very simple one. Now, hence it is proved that in purely resistive circuit, the current and voltage both are in same phase. Since in the voltage there is no phase phi, since in the current there is no phase phi, it means we can see both voltage and current are in same phase. Now we have to draw the waveform and the phasor diagram from the expression of voltage and current. See how to draw the waveform. Since this is a sinusoidal quantity, the waveform will be also sinusoidal one. Okay. Now, firstly drawing the waveform of voltage. This blue line is indicating, blue waveform is indicating the voltage waveform, whereas the red is indicating the current waveform. On the same axis, we have to draw both the waveforms. Starting both the waveforms from the 0. Since there is no phase angle, therefore both the waveform will start from the same point. Okay. The magnitude of current is somewhat lesser than voltage, therefore the magnitude of current is shown lesser than the voltage. They'll start from the 0, increases to its maximum positive value, again reaches to 0 at 180 degree, again reaches to इट्स अ नेगेटिव मैक्सिमम वैल्यू एंड कंप्लीट्स इट्स साइकिल एट 360 डिग्री और वी कैन से 2 पाई. सिंस बोथ द वेव फॉर्म आर लुकिंग सेम और द जीरो क्रॉसिंग इज सेम देयरफॉर वी कैन से द करंट एंड वोल्टेज बोथ आर इन सेम फेज. ओके नाउ दिस इज द फेजर डायग्राम. फर्स्टली ड्रॉ द वोल्टेज फेजर along the positive x-axis, that is the blue line. Okay, since the current is also having no phasor, therefore the current is to be drawn in the same phase or in the same line with laser magnitude. Okay, the question may ask, obtain the expression of a voltage and current, draw the waveforms and the phasor diagram. This will be the solution for the question. Understood? Okay, now the next point. Instantaneous power in purely resistive circuit. Okay, the question may ask, obtain the instantaneous power in purely resistive circuit. We know that the power is a product of instantaneous voltage and current. And we know that V is equal to Vm sin of omega t, I is equal to Im sin of omega t. Okay, taking the product of voltage and current, what we are getting? Vm into Im sin omega t into sin omega t, it will become sin square of omega t. Now, we know that mathematically sin square of omega t is equal to 1 minus cos of 2 omega t divided by 2. The 2 is taken here. So it will be Vm into Im by 2 into bracket 1 minus cos omega t. Now opening this bracket, Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 into cos 2 omega t. Okay, this 2 can also be written as root 2 into root 2. Okay, mathematically is it okay? Now this is the equation of instantaneous power in purely resistive circuit. In this expression, there are two terms. Say this is first term and say this is second term. The first term is the constant power component. There is no fluctuating component, therefore the first term is also called as constant power component. Whereas the second term, which is having cos 2 omega t, this term is also called as fluctuating component. Since it is having omega, omega means the frequency, means fluctuating. It is 2 omega, means double the frequency. So the second term is called as fluctuating component having frequency doubled than the applied frequency. Now, if we need to calculate the average power consumed by this pure resistive circuit, how to calculate it? Average power by first component and then average power by the second component over the complete cycle. Okay. Now the average power for the first component will be Vm by root 2, Im by root 2. We know that Vm by root 2 is nothing but Vrms. Im by root 2 is nothing but Irms. These are the RMS value of voltage and current. And average value of the second fluctuating term over a complete cycle will be 0. Since it is fluctuating component having doubled the frequency than the applied voltage. Okay. Therefore, the average power for this second term will be 0. So, minus 0. Therefore, the average power for the pure resistive circuit is given by V into I. The unit of power is what? It is measured in watts. Okay. At the same time, you have to draw the waveforms as well. How to draw the waveform? Already we know the waveforms of voltage and current. For purely resistive circuit, both voltage and current are in same phase. Therefore, the blue waveform and the red waveform are in same phase. Their zero crossings are same. At the zero, they start at zero. They reaches at a positive maximum value at the same instant. They reaches at the next zero at same instant. That is 180 degree. negative maximum is at same instant, and then they complete their cycle at 360 degree, that is same instant. Now we have to obtain the power waveform. How to obtain the power waveform? What is power? It is a product of voltage into current. Okay. Now for this positive half cycle, we will multiply voltage with the current to get this power waveform. When both the waveforms are positive, obviously the power waveform will also be positive for the positive half cycle. Okay. Now, during negative half cycle, both the quantity voltage and current are negative. Mathematically, negative into negative becomes positive. Therefore, the instantaneous power in the resistive circuit during negative half cycle will be positive. For positive, it is positive. For negative half cycle also, it is positive. For resistive circuit, it cannot be negative. This is the instantaneous power for purely resistive circuit. Very easy. Similarly, we have to obtain the same for inductive circuit. This is purely inductive circuit consisting of pure inductance of L Henry's, which is connected across a voltage given by the equation Vm sine of omega t. Okay, understood this circuit diagram? Instead of resistance, we have connected one pure inductor, and a voltage of Vm sine omega t is applied across this inductor. When the alternating current I flows through this inductor, it sets up the alternating magnetic field around the inductance. Due to the changing flux linking with the coil and due to self inductance, the EMF get induced in this coil. And according to Lenz's law, this EMF opposes the applied voltage. The self-induced EMF is given by the equation E is equal to minus L di by dt. This negative sign is because of Lenz's law. At all the instant, the applied voltage V is equal to and opposite to the self-induced EMF. V is equal to minus of E. Or we can write V is equal to minus. What is E? E is equal to minus L di by dt. So minus and minus will become plus. What is V? V is equal to Vm sine omega t. Substituting this, instead of V, Vm sine of omega t, which is equal to L di by dt. Rearranging the equation, keeping di at one side and taking all the remaining terms at one side. So what will be the equation? Di is equal to Vm divided by this L into sine omega t into this dt. This is the equation. Okay. We have to obtain the equation of current. Therefore, taking derivative of this equation. Taking integration of this equation. Okay. By taking integration of this equation, what we are getting? I is equal to Vm divided by omega L into bracket minus cos of omega t. Mathematically, you might be knowing integration of sine is minus cos omega t divided by omega. That omega we have taken beside this L. Getting? Now, again we know that minus cos of omega t is equivalent to what? Sine omega t minus of pi by 2. Now, what is omega L? Omega L is nothing but XL. What is XL? XL is inductive reactance. What is the formula of XL? It is 2 pi FL. Okay. This is the final equation of current. Fourth equation. Now, we have to compare this equation with the standard equation of current. Remember, what is the standard equation of current? I is equal to Im sine of omega t plus pi. Okay, before the sign Im, before the sign, what is it? Is Vm divided by XL. What does it mean? The Im is equal to Vm divided by XL. What will be the value of phi? It is minus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2 is equivalent to what? 90 degree. It means the standard equation of current I for purely inductive circuit is I am sine of omega t minus pi by 2, where V is equal to Vm sine of omega t. Understood? What does it mean? If the voltage is started at the zeroth phase, the current is lagging behind the voltage by what angle? By 90 degree. This a negative sign indicates the lagging phase. What this negative sign indicates? It indicates the lagging phase. Let us draw the waveforms and the phasor diagram from both the equations, from the equation of voltage and the equation of current. This is the voltage waveform which has started from the zeroth instant, okay, completing its cycle at this 2 pi or 360 degree. Since the current is having the phase phi is equal to minus pi by 2, means the current will start its waveform after pi by 2. This is the pi by 2, okay, where the voltage has already reached to its maximum value. At this instant, the current will start its waveform. It means the current is lagging behind this voltage by angle 90 degree. And then it will be a cycle of current. Understood? Now, the phasor diagram. The same voltage is drawn in the positive x-axis. Okay. Current is lagging behind the voltage by what angle? By 90 degree. Lagging phasor is shown in clockwise direction. So, in the clockwise direction at an angle 90 degree, there will be a current phasor. It means the current is lagging behind the voltage by angle 90 degree. Is it clear with you? Okay. The next point. The next point will be instantaneous power in purely inductive circuit. In the same way as we have obtained for purely resistive circuit. The question on this particular point may ask like this: show that the average power consumed by pure inductor is zero. The average power consumed by pure inductor is 0. We have to show that, we have to prove that. Now let's see how to prove this. The expression for instantaneous power can be obtained by taking the product of instantaneous voltage and instantaneous current. Okay, the P is equal to V into I. For pure inductor, what is V? It is Vm sine of omega t. And what is I? It is Im sine of omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, taking the product of these two, what we are getting? Vm into Im sin omega t into sin omega t minus pi by 2 is equivalent to what? Minus cos of omega t. Okay, now taking this minus sign right here, it is Vm into Im sin omega t into cos omega t. We are multiplying and dividing this equation by 2. Okay. Mathematically, it is completely okay. Now, what is this 2 sin omega t into cos omega t? This is equivalent to what? This is equivalent to sin of 2 omega t. And this 2 can be written as Vm by root 2, Im by root 2. Okay, is it acceptable? Okay. Therefore, the average power for purely inductive circuit is minus Vm by root 2, Im by root 2 into sin of 2 omega t. This power curve is sine curve of frequency double than that of the applied voltage, twice means doubled. The average value of the sine curve over a complete cycle is always 0. Okay. Therefore, the average power in purely inductive circuit is equal to 0. We can also observe it. These are the waveforms. How to obtain the waveform? This is the voltage waveform, blue line, blue waveform, and this is the current waveform. See, during this interval, zero crossings, both the quantities, voltage and current, both are positive, means the power will also positive. Now, during this duration, okay, during this duration, the voltage is negative and the current is positive. If anyone is negative, the power will be negative. In the next interval, during this interval, both the quantities are negative, therefore the product will be positive. Therefore, in a half cycle, there will be two cycles of power. In a half cycles, there will be again two cycles of power. It means the frequency of power is doubled. Now, what can be observed from this waveform? It can be observed from it that when power curve is positive, the energy get induced in the magnetic field established due to increasing current, while during the negative power, this power is returned back to supply. And also, the area of positive loop and negative loop are exactly same, equal. Hence, we can say the average power consumption for purely inductive circuit is zero. Therefore, the pure inductor never consumes any power. Do remember, this is what about the pure inductive circuit. The next is purely capacitive circuit. Consider a simple circuit consisting of pure capacitor of C farad, which is connected across a voltage given by the equation V is equal to Vm sine of omega t. The current I, it changes the capacitor C. The instantaneous charge Q on the plate of capacitor is given by. The instantaneous charge on plate of capacitor is given by Q is equal to Cv. Q is equal to Cv. What is V? V is applied voltage, whose equation is Vm sine of omega t. Current. Current is the rate of flow of charge. I is equal to dQ divided by dt. What is Q? Q is Cv. Okay, substituting Q is equal to Cv. What is V? V is equal to Vm sine omega t. Therefore, I is equal to d divided by dt C into Vm sine of omega t. Okay, we have to take the derivative of this term. C and Vm are the constant term, taking outside of the derivative. Therefore, derivative of sine omega t is what? It is cos omega t into omega. Cos omega t into this omega. Rearranging this equation, Vm divided by 1 minus of this omega c. Sorry, 1 by this omega c. Just rearranging. What is cos omega t? Cos omega t is equivalent to what? Sin omega t plus pi by 2. Okay. What is 1 by omega c? 1 by omega c is equivalent to xc. What is xc? It's capacitive reactance. What is the formula? 1 divided by 2 pi fc. Now, this is the final equation of current flowing through this capacitor. Okay. Now, comparing this equation of current with the standard equation. What is the standard equation? I is equal to Im sine of omega t plus phi. Before the sine, Im. Before the sine, what is the term? It is Vm divided by Xc. Means the maximum value of current flowing through the capacitor is Vm by Xc. Phi. Okay, what is phi? It is plus pi by 2. Phi is what? For pure capacitor, the angle phi is plus pi by 2. Therefore, the equation of current is I is equal to Im sine of omega t plus phi. It means in purely capacitive circuit, the current leads the voltage by angle 90 degree. Plus is indicating the leading one, minus for lagging one. Let us show this with the waveform and the phasor diagram. Okay. This is the voltage phasor. Sorry, this is the voltage waveform starting from the 0th value okay, and completing its one cycle. Since the current I is Im sine of omega t plus pi by 2, plus is for leading, therefore the current waveform will start before the voltage. Current waveform will start before the voltage, before 90 degree it will start. Okay, now how to draw the phasor diagram? This is the voltage phasor along the positive x-axis. Since the current is leading behind the voltage, therefore the leading phasor is shown in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, in purely capacitive circuit, the current leads the voltage by angle 90 degree. Now next we have to obtain the instantaneous power for purely capacitive circuit. Again the same, the power is the product of voltage into current. The voltage is Vm sin omega t and the current is Im sin omega t plus pi by 2. Do remember, for purely capacitive circuit it is plus pi by 2. For inductor it is minus pi by 2. Okay, then mathematically it is Vm Im sin omega t into sin omega t plus pi by 2 is equivalent to cos omega t. Okay, now multiplying and dividing the equation by 2, and this term 2 sin omega t into cos omega t is equivalent to sin of 2 omega t. This is the final equation of the of your instantaneous power for purely capacitive circuit. The power curve is a sine curve of a frequency double than that of the applied voltage. Therefore, the average value of the sine curve over a complete cycle will be zero. Therefore, the average power for this pure capacitive circuit will also be zero. You can also show it from the waveform also. Okay, instead of capacitor, inductor, it is capacitor. Okay, this is the voltage phase waveform, this is the current waveform. The current is leading behind the voltage, it has started already before the voltage. Now during this duration, both voltage and current are positive, therefore voltage is positive. Now during this duration, current is negative, voltage is positive, therefore the power is negative. During this interval, both are negative, therefore power is positive. Current positive, voltage negative, therefore power is negative. Okay, in a single cycle of voltage, how many cycles of power are there? There are 2 cycles of power, means double the frequency than the applied voltage. Okay, during the positive half cycle, the capacitor will store the energy, and during the negative half cycle, it will return back the energy. Again will store, again will return. Therefore, we can say the pure capacitor will never consumes any power. This is what about the lecture 1. Let us see what are the important questions based on this lecture 1. I have segregated the questions based on the content. The question based on pure R. What will be asked? Prove that voltage and current in purely resistive circuit are in phase. Okay. The second question on pure R will be, for a single phase AC circuit, the applied voltage is given, V is equal to Vm sin omega t, and the current drawn is also given, I is equal to Im sin omega t. Derive the expression of average power, okay, and draw the waveforms of voltage, current and instantaneous power over the one cycle of voltage. The same we did in the starting of this lecture. Now question based on pure inductor, it may ask, show that the average power consumed by pure inductor is zero. I have shown you mathematically, I have shown you graphically, both are expected in this question. Okay, no need to derive the expression of current, you just need to obtain the expression of average power from the expression of voltage and current. Okay, and the second question, obtain the expression of instantaneous current and power consumed when voltage V is equal to Vm sin omega t two pure inductors. Also draw the phasor diagram. Okay, very simple. Now next is questions on pure C, pure capacitance. Show that average power consumed by pure capacitor is zero. This will be similar to pure inductor. Okay, only the expression of current will be changed. Okay, in pure inductor I was Im sin of omega t minus pi by 2, whereas in capacitor it is Im sin omega t plus pi by 2. Okay, and at the end the average power consumed by both capacitor and inductor both are zero. Okay, you have to show it mathematically by the expression as well as graphically by the waveform. Do remember. Okay, both will carry the mark. Second question will be, obtain the expression of instantaneous current and power consumed when applied voltage is Vm sin omega t to the pure capacitor alone. Okay, and at the same time it is asked to draw the phasor diagram. This is all about the pure capacitor, pure resistor and pure inductor. Okay, best of luck.